हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, योर टॉपिक फॉर टुडे इज अमेंडमेंट ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन। सो अमेंडमेंट ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इम्प्लाइज चेंजिंग सर्टेन प्रोविजंस और अपडेटिंग फ्यू एक्सटर्नल फीचर्स टू मीट द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ द डे। फॉर द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन टू रिफ्लेक्ट द रियलिटी एंड नेसेसिटी ऑफ द डे, प्रोविजन ऑफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल अमेंडमेंट इज वेरी नेसेसरी। So the requirements for the constitutional amendment, the necessity for the amendment of the constitution can be emphasized as, first, if there had been no provision of the amendment, the people and the leaders would have adhered to some extra constitutional mean like revolution, violence and so on, thereby diluting the very constitution per se. So the provisions for the amendment of the constitution is made with a view to overcome the difficulties which may encounter in future in the working of the constitution. It is also necessary in order to fix loopholes at the time of constitution enactment. Ideals, priorities and vision of the people vary greatly generation to generation. In order to cooperate, these amendments is desirable. So the procedures for amending the constitution. Constitution can be amended by various methods, namely simple majority, special majority, ratification by at least half the states. Constitutional amendment under Article 368 is considered as the cure amendment procedure in the Indian constitution, whose procedure can be explained as follows. It can be laid in any house of the parliament. It cannot be introduced in state legislature. The bill can be introduced either by a minister or a private member. The permission of the president is not required to introduce the bill in either house of the parliament. The bill must be passed by each house separately. It should be passed by special majority, that is of the two-thirds of members present and voting, and not less than 50% of total strength. The ratification by at least half of the state is imperative in case of amendment of any federal feature of the Indian constitution. After all the above steps, the bill is presented before the president, where he has no option but to sign. However, the time period has not been set for the president to act on the bill. Once the president gives his assent, the bill becomes an act. So the types of amendment. Under the ambit of Article 368 of the Constitution, there are two types of amendment to the Constitution of India. The first one is special majority of the Parliament only, and the second one is special majority of Parliament along with the ratification of half of the states by a simple majority.
First, India does not have any permanent constitutional amendment body, unlike many other countries, and all the effort is carried by a relatively naive and immature parliament. Second, state legislature, except having the power to initiate the establishment or abolition of legislative council, do not have any other scope of initiating amendments procedure. This makes the Indian constitution a monopoly of center, as well as makes it too rigid for the states. The existence of two houses of the parliament makes it difficult to pass the Constitutional Amendment Act owing to the disagreement between the houses. Fourth, there is hardly any difference between normal legislative function and constitutional amendment function. Fifth, there are too much of loopholes. For example, there is a possibility of amending the presidential impeachment process, reducing two-thirds of the total strength to two-thirds of the present and voting, and hence in case the ruling party, if unable to muster two-thirds majority of total strength, it can always devise such a technique to suit his way. Sixth, there is no time frame for state legislature to ratify. Seventh, there is no time frame for the president to give his assent. Describing the constitutional amendment procedure of the Indian constitution, K.G. Balakrishnan has rightly said that amending the constitution strikes a good balance between flexibility and rigidity. Moreover, Granville Austen, a renowned scholar of the Indian Indian Constitution said the amending process has proved itself as one of the most ably conceived aspects of the Constitution. Although it appears complicated, it is very diverse. That's all. Thank you.